Everybody, what's going on? This is Matt Holmes with BodySynergyTraining.com and InsaneMuscleGains.com. So it's Monday, what is it? October, let me check. I don't even know what day it is. October 6th. So it would be day three of training today. Almost a week on the program, actually. Wednesday will be the 1 week. So I'll weigh myself in and share with you guys what I got going on then of progresses. As far as what I'm eating today, this morning, I did make a shake, had 2 cups of low-fat milk, 2 scoops of protein, some greens powder, and some fish oil, and it had that because I woke up a little bit late and had to run and teach boot camp. So now I'm back from that, from teaching boot camp classes. This is what I have going on so far. I have my Starbucks iced green tea, good stuff. My oatmeal, which is a little bit more than a cup, a little bit more than three servings, strawberries, a piece of toast with a little bit of peanut butter with some fat. So you can see, yeah, there is no really protein in this meal, but that's because I had it earlier, so now I'm making up for the carbs I didn't have this morning. So I'll get you guys later with a little bit of update of what else I'm eating today, and then also my workout. All right, talk to you soon. Bye. Hey everybody, what's going on? It's Matt here again. So it's my first snack of the day after I had my breakfast, about two and a half hours later. Show you what I got going on here. I got about a little bit more than a cup of milk in there, a cup of oats, some of my total EFA, a tablespoon of peanut butter, a banana's in there too, and then 2 scoops of muscle milk. So that's what I got going on for the first snack right here, and then about 2 hours I'll have something to eat, and then I gotta work out. So, alright man, talk to you guys soon. Hey everybody, what's going on? It's Matt Holmes with BodySynergyTraining.com and InsaneMuscleGains.com. So it's workout number 3 today. What we got today? We got a mobility warm-up that I just did, doing a high rep squat day. Then we're gonna do some kettlebell front squats, partner glute ham raise, and then at the end we're gonna do a circuit of calf raises with the barbell, and a little bit of ab work. So I'll be taking some videos throughout the workout, put them all together, and show you guys. All right.
I can see. All right. So we didn't film the high rep squats. Kind of forgot I was trying to get in the zone there. So now we did 4 sets of those, 20 reps, basically as many as you can get out. Now we got a kettlebell front squats. I don't have same kettlebell weight, so it's gonna be a little bit offset. So each time, go for 4 sets, switch heavy left, you know, heavy right, switch back and forth so it evens out. Kind of throws you off, adds a little bit of extra spice in there. So here we go. All right, so here we go. Finish the kettlebell front squats. Now we're gonna do the partner glute ham raise.
Teddy Swallows, Indigo Ranch, alive with the vibe. Grundy, Danny at the milk bar, Terry Parker, you know what's up. Dialed into the planet, and God, I love you.
Everybody, what's going on? So we finished the glute ham raise. Now it's off to the kettlebell, or I don't know what that's going on there. The barbell calf raises, and then we're gonna do the ab rollout with the wheel. All right, here we go.
Take my words and have an impact like this. I must have struck a chord with somebody up in the office, cause karma keeps telling me I ain't causing nothing but problems, and now they're saying I'm
with those. You want to make sure you know my feet aren't touching the ground. You want to keep those up. Try and keep your butt from sticking up. And don't come all the way back up when you're done. Come as far as you can. Come back up right here. That way your abs are still contracted the whole time. When you come up here, they rest for a second. So keep that tension on the whole time. Try and get about 10 to 12 of those. All right. Everybody, what's going on? All right, so that's the finish of the workout for today. Got a good one planned for Wednesday, which will be an upper body workout, kind of what we did on day two, but a little bit extra different style mixed in with it. So immediately after I have my workout, I always get my post-workout shake, just get those extra calories and get my body filled up as fast as I can, and then I'll eat within a half hour afterwards. What I do in this one, I have two scoops of just whey protein, so it's about almost 50 grams. And then I have two scoops of a waxy maize, which is just basically reloads my glycogen, which is a carb. And that's about 75 grams. So 75 grams of carbs and about 50 grams of protein immediately after. Usually I'll start drinking it in the middle as well, too, depending on how hungry I am. I started it towards the end of the workout today. So, all right, see you guys tomorrow.
Hey, everybody, what's going on? This is Matt Holmes with BodySynergyTraining.com and InsaneMuscleGains.com. So it's about the end of the night. Just finished training my last group of guys for the night. Making some eggs right now. Did about 2 cups of eggs, as you can see. And then gonna get in a little bit more fat, probably just through some like a tablespoon of peanut butter. Going low on the carbs tonight, so just going with some broccoli. And then before I go to bed, have another little shake with just some yogurt, some protein powder, and a little bit of extra greens powder. So I'll be posting this up for you guys to see tomorrow, and if you guys got any comments or any questions, please feel free to post them or email me at matt@bodysynergytraining.com. All right, talk to you later. Bye.